Leafs and the Titanic have in common? They're both great until they hit the ice.
There's only one true superstar of the decade, true superstar of the millennium. You know who that is? The Rock will tell you who that is. Toronto, that is the jabroni beaten now, pie eating, trailblazing, eyebrow raising, stronger than a bear, faster than a buck, the biggest thing to hit Canada because the Maple Leafs suck.
Oh! Hello out there, we're on the air, it's hockey night tonight. Tension grows, the whistle blows, and the puck goes down the ice. The goalie jumps and the players bump and the fans all go insane. Someone roars, Bobby scores at the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game. Second period.
I'm from near Detroit. When you're from near Detroit and you're a Detroit fan, you hate the Leafs. It's rule, it's law.
But they grab the puck and go bursting up and they're down across the line. They storm the crease like bumblebees.
I've been ranting about this team for years. And then people walk up to me and they go, hey Steve, what are you going to do now that the Leafs are good? Where? Who? What? When? Where were they good? And the answer to that until recently was standings. Monster standings!
You can name is the good old hockey game. Third period, last game in the playoffs, too. Oh, it takes me where the hockey players face off down the rink. And the Stanley Cup is all filled up for the champs who win the drink. Now the final flick of a hockey stick and a one gigantic scream. The puck is in, the home team wins the good old hockey game.
What do you hate most of the Leafs?
That they're the Leafs.
History repeats itself. The Boston Bruins beat the Toronto Maple Leafs in Game 7 again.